Wave 105's Cash for Kids has been working very closely with the team from FJB Hotels. We're out finding just where some of the money that they have been raising has gone.
My name's Tracy Parsons. I'm a lead ISVA. We work in Dorset Rape Crisis Support Centre.
What's ISVA?
ISVA is an independent sexual violence advisor. There's sort of three strings to our bow. We have the ISVA team, which is myself and four other ISVAs. We offer practical support for any victims of rape, sexual assault, sexual violence. So that may be going to court with them, to helping them with police investigations, attending meetings, and just giving them a bit of emotional support when they've been through a huge ordeal that they've gone through.
What kind of support do the young people who you would be dealing with need on a practical level?
Young people, on the whole, tend to leave because of what's happened to them. They have, very similar to adults, quite a chaotic lifestyles, and they struggle with so many different things, in particular schooling. When something like this has happened, especially if they're in the school education system, that has a huge effect on them. So they need, as much as they need some practical stuff, they need emotional, and they need to give them some support around how they're going to cope and be able to hopefully move on when something like this has happened to them.
My name is Lauren Ward, and I'm the fundraising and marketing assistant at Dorset Rape Crisis Support Centre.
Okay, and you were the person who actually put in the grant application. What are you specifically looking to spend the money on?
We kind of have done research on the children that we do support, especially the young teenagers. We found that children often, because of the crisis that they're going through, forget to eat throughout the day or don't want to eat. And what we kind of realised was important is, in order for them to concentrate during the sessions, to have something to eat, and it also builds trust with the ISVA as well. And we also, because of the kind of type of people that live in Dorset, there's often a kind of low amount of income coming in, and unfortunately they can't afford travel to get to their sessions either. So we kind of decided that would be a good kind of combination of travel and food expenses.
So it's real practical stuff then?
Yeah, definitely more practical, but it is kind of tapers into the emotional side because they do need that kind of support as well.
Okay, my name's Helen Cook. I am the Children and Young Persons ISVA here at Dorset Rape Crisis. My role usually, as I say, takes me from, you know, the initial referral right through to any police investigation, a court case, and then for about 6 months after, just to hopefully get them to a place where actually they can start rebuilding their lives how they would have been before any of this trauma happened. So it can be 2 years.
I was going to say, so you get to see the families effectively from start to finish and after the process. And what kind of difference does it, you know, how are they after the 2 years?
I mean, as an example, I'm closely working with young people at the moment who are taking exams at school. So, you know, they may not have been attending initially, so it's working closely with schools to look at, you know, how best we can support, you know, on maybe a reduced timetable, you know, a place where they feel actually safe in school. In that respect, parents are then feel as though they're being supported because they haven't got that added worry following such a trauma of getting their child to school. So, you know, my work is, you know, really holistically for everybody.
There we go. So this is where your money's going. You can see that it really goes to the people who need it. And if you want to find out more about Wave 105's Cash for Kids, everything is on the website at wave105.com/cashforkids.